Hi, it's Rachel here from off-road.cc, and this week the 2021 Nukeproof Reactor range has launched, and we've had one in on test ahead of that launch. If you missed it, the Reactor was born last year in September 2019, a short travel trail bike for the Nukeproof brand. The Reactor name wasn't new though, it used to be a hardtail from 20 years ago. But this new bike got suspension and looked well sorted with modern geometry, a flip chip for adjustment and carbon seat stays on alloy bikes too to reduce unsprung weight. It's safe to say that back then we were keen to have a ride on one, and now is our time. First of all though, we'll get through the updates for the 2021 bikes. For the main part, the geometry and the travel all stays the same. And then as an easy to digest list, here's the details. It's still available in 27.5 and 29er versions in both carbon and alloy. It's still 140mm of rear travel on the 27.5 inch bikes and 130mm on the 29ers. The flip chip's still there, and the bikes all still use those carbon seat stays at the rear too. There's still that RS version, which gets 10mm more travel on the front and the rear, and that gives it slightly slacker geometry. And you can still fit 2.6 inch tyres on both wheel sizes across the range. There's other neat features that stay too. There's a nice chain slack protector, plus that all important fact that you can fit a 750ml water bottle inside the front triangle. Sort of new for this year is a shorter travel version. So they did it in a limited run last year, and that's the bike that I have here. This is the Reactor ST. So it's a 29er with 125mm of rear travel and 130mm fork. So comparing that to the normal Reactor, if the normal Reactor in a medium gets a 451mm reach, a head angle of 65.5 and a wheelbase of 1205mm with chainstays of 440mm and an effective seat angle of 75 degrees, the ST I have here is slightly steeper in the low position at 66 degree head angle and, for example, a 75.5 degree seat angle. As I said, the flip chip's still there and it adjusts the geometry from what Nukeproof are calling trail or rail mode, rail being the low mode. Trail, they say, is best suited for trail riding, for those riding both uphill and downhill. This mode, for example, on the 290 bike, gives a 66 degree head angle and a 75.5 degree effective seat tube angle. And then it's slacker in the rail mode, so it slackens the head angle and the effective seat tube angle by half a degree to 65.5 and 75 degrees for the seat angle. The 27.5 inch bike is slightly slacker at both of these angles at 65 and 65.5 for the two different positions and 75 and 74.5 degrees for the seat angle respectively. So, like I said, if you think this ST sounds a little familiar, then you'd be right. It was launched as a limited edition model in 2020, but it's now ready to be in the main lineup for the whole of 2021. Nukeproof say that this was originally conceived for Sam Hill to race XC on during the off-season. It's designed as a fast hooligan for epic adventures. Our bike here gets 130mm Fox 34 Float Factory Series fork with a Grip 2 damper. It also gets a Fox Float DPS shock, and Shimano takes care of the gears and the braking too, with XT 2-piston brakes and XT 12-speed drivetrain. The wheels on this bike are a set of DT Swiss XR 1700 Spline 25s, with slightly faster rolling tyres than the rest of the range, with a Maxxis Minion DHF and a Maxxis Aggressor, both in 2.3. Elsewhere, there's a Nukeproof cockpit, a bike yoke dropper post and Sam Hill grips. All that comes in at £4,300. Before I get into how this bike rides, I'll give you a quick overview of the specs of the rest of the range, all of which are available as 27.5 inch or 29er bikes. So first up is that longer travel carbon framed RS bike, which costs £5,500 and gets a RockShox Lyric fork, a Super Deluxe Ultimate RCT shock and SRAM X1 drivetrain with Code RSC brakes. The next bike in the lineup is the factory bike, which is also carbon. This one is a Fox and Shimano setup, so it gets Fox 36 factory forks with a DPX2 factory shock and Shimano XT all round. The factory price tops that RS at £4,900. The elite version of the bike is up next, and that gets Fox 36 performance fork, a DPX2 performance elite shock and Shimano SLX 12 speed with SLX 4 piston brakes. That's slightly cheaper, so the elite version of the bike costs £4,000, but a penny. Next up is the Pro model, and this is the first of the aluminium bikes, and we're back to RockShox for this one. So this bike has a Pike Select Plus fork and a Super Deluxe Select Plus shock, plus SRAM, GX Eagle and Guide RE brakes. Like all of the above bikes, the tyres are pretty rowdy, so all the bikes in the range get Maxxis Assegai WT3C Max Terra XO Plus tyres and a Detector WT at the rear. That alloy bike, just to remind you, starts at £3,400. Last but not least is the comp. So this is the base spec alloy bike. There's a Marzocchi Bomber Z2 and a Super Deluxe Select R rear shock. Plus it gets Dior 12 speed and 4-piston Dior brakes. Also, don't forget that also gets that capable tyre lineup too. Comp bikes in both sizes again cost £2,700 but a penny. So how does the bike I have here ride? As you've just heard from the specs, this is a shorter travel version of the trail bike, and as such appears to have quite a different character. The 125mm of travel at the rear makes this bike feel lively and responsive to ride, which is great on flowy, flatter trails where you feel loads of feedback from the trail. That feedback also means that you quickly know when the bike is getting out of its depth too. But that's no bad thing. It's what makes this bike significantly different to the longer travel, burlier versions. The rear suspension is pretty compliant in the early stages of the travel too. It's active and you could be quick to forget that you're on a short travel bike. This is also in part though to the pretty balanced geometry, which with a more supportive fork and winter-worthy tyres that you might find on the other bikes, makes me really keen to ride those 130mm 29er bikes on my normal trails too. This ST version is for longer miles and adventures. It's relatively light at £30 on the nose, and with the shock locked out or in the middle setting for trail mode for firmness, it cancelled out some of the bobbin and it made the bike feel a lot more efficient uphill. The Reactor range has something for everyone, whether it's from this downcountry spec bike to the brawl of a bike in the RS spec, which looks keen for some trouble. Riders just need to take their pick based on their style of riding, whether that's winch and plummet or smiles for miles on this ST version. So I'll be back online on www.off.road.cc with a full review in words, so keep an eye out on our site for that. Over here on YouTube, next week we will have details of another brand new short travel bike, so make sure you subscribe and then turn those notifications on so you get an alert when that bike goes live. As ever, thanks very much for watching and I'll catch you again soon.